For many years, we have put ourselves, as a species, above all other life forms, believing that there was something magical about us. However, over the course of our existence, science allowed us to realize that in fact, we are no different from any other living organism, and we learned that all life is just an incredibly complex pile of dead stuff. We learned about the trillions of chemical reactions that happen within us. Eventually, we learned about the countless species that came before us, and learned that we are descendants of one-celled creatures. One of our more recent descendants, the Neanderthals, has often been thought of as the inferior species, the dumber, more rugged race. Many people stated that the Neanderthals had worse tools, so they went extinct, or perhaps they were killed by the early humans. However, recent research and DNA analysis has made many experts develop new theories about what actually happened to the Neanderthals and what that means for our story. After evolving 300,000 years ago, our ancient ancestors that originated in Africa ventured out to the other continents 30,000 years into their history. However, these first Homo sapiens that went to colonize the distant lands suddenly disappeared once they reached Europe, or at least that is what the fossils suggested. But what had happened? Let's get to learn a bit more about what happened before this mysterious event. DNA research from both the nucleus of the cell, that has both paternal and maternal DNA, and the mitochondria of the cell, which only has maternal DNA, can let us learn more about the fascinating plot that twists and turns about our human history. In the 2000s, a new finger bone discovered in a cave called Denisova in Siberia shocked the world of scientists with a perplexing puzzle. The sequence of mitochondrial DNA found in the finger bone was unique, not human nor Neanderthal, but a completely different branch of the family. These were the Denisovans, who were more closely related to the Neanderthals. The common ancestor between the Denisovans, humans, and Neanderthals was later discovered to live between 765,000 and 550,000 years ago, and split into two lineages, one leading to humans and the other branching out to Denisovans and Neanderthals. After more fossil analysis, a theory was developed that the common ancestor of Denisovans and Neanderthals that lived around 400,000 years ago began to split into two genetic lineages, one leading east with Denisovans, the other leading west with Neanderthals. The many Neanderthal fossils found in the east with Denisovan DNA show the early split of the species. Later in history, Neanderthals all had nearly identical mitochondrial DNA, all from an ancestor that lived in Europe 270,000 years ago. But everything changed when early Homo sapiens from Africa had migrated into Europe. These voyagers that we had mentioned earlier had not disappeared. This population had interbred with the Neanderthals. This added countless new snippets of DNA into the gene pool, giving a completely new mitochondrial DNA composition. As more and more humans arrived, the gene pool became more and more diverse, giving us unique new traits that allowed our species to prosper in other climates and survive in new conditions. So, this theory states that we had never been more adept than the Neanderthals and caused them to die out. No, we had become part of the Neanderthals, and that allowed us to colonize the world. Our videos take 20 to 25 hours to make, so it would really help a lot if you showed your support by liking this video, sharing it with all your friends, and of course subscribing and clicking that little bell to get notifications. This video showed how sometimes things are not what they seem to be. So as usual, always dig deep.